Okay, I've reduced the reel down now from 9 1/4 inches to about 8 1/4. So consequently, because I did muck up, there's no question about it. So the consequently, the margin for error is going to be less. Let's give this one a try. And again, as I say, I'll try and use it the correct way, which is using one of the gear wheels out the back, which is designed for turning it around, as opposed to using a wheel to turn it, which is causes it to potentially spin on the spindle. Now, to drop it down to a satisfactory height, I usually just use a piece of 3mm MDF. Lower it down onto there, make sure it's relatively horizontal. It doesn't have to be. Lock this in. It's also just to stop the wheel or the bottom of the wheel dragging on the tabletop, creating unnecessary friction and forces on the wheel. So if we remove that, now I think I raise, I'll leave the blade exactly where it is. And let's give it a try, but as I said, this time I'll use this, as you can see, there's still a bit of play available in it, so I'll try and use it on as it is, and we'll see what happens. Okay, the magic starts the thing, and off we go. And the last one, and hopefully you should return to the same spot without much difference. Now that to me is pretty good. I'm happy with that, and I'm happy that all occurs. And I'll try one more. You shouldn't have any additional, it's touching, but hell, it might have increased the curve by 100,000 millionth of a short fly dip, and that's it. So I'm quite happy with that. All right, that's it for now.